Hey guys, Arleesha here and welcome to another video. Today we're going to be hanging out in my sketchbook and doing some gouache painting. It's going to be a bit of a mess, but we're going to have fun together. And thank you so much to those of you who left comments over in the community section with some ideas for what I could do for this video. I was kind of at a bit of a loss. As you can see there, I'm going to be working from some Pinterest sort of inspirations, a couple of color combinations and lighting of foliage and things like that I found really inspiring. So I'm going to be kind of mashing a couple ideas together just to see what we get. I do want to go ahead and take a minute right at the beginning of this video to announce the winners of my 100K giveaway. We have three separate prizes and all of the winners have been selected and also contacted. So winners, you guys should have received emails from me or messages from me yesterday at the time this video goes live, and of course I'm going to officially announce them here, and those winners will have a couple of days to reply to my email. And if I don't hear back from them soon, within the next couple of days, probably by the end of this week, I will choose new winners. But the official announcement is here and now, and oh my goodness, I'm sorry for making you wait so long to hear them. The first winner for our ArtX art supplies bundle is Lania. Yay, congratulations. The second winner for the Arlie's merch bundle, which is a bunch of art prints and an original and some fun stuff from me, is Alexandra. So congratulations to you. And the third winner of the Peerless Watercolors giveaway that was happening over on Instagram is Lillian, or Mother the Butter. So thank you for giving me the opportunity to say that in a video that thousands of people will probably see. Congratulations to all three of our winners. If you are watching this video before having seen my message slash email, please just do get back to me with your name and mailing address and all that fun stuff so I can either send out your prizes or send your information along to the company so that we can all get those prizes out as soon as possible. Thank you guys all so much for your support and making giveaways like this possible. I definitely want to keep doing more of them in the future, and there were over 5,000 total entries across the three giveaways, which was really, really exciting for me to see. So thank you all so much for joining in and celebrating this milestone with me. While all of that announcing has been going on, I've been scribbling away in my sketchbook with some ideas. I'm using a felt tip brush pen here. I'm actually not entirely sure what brand this guy is, but I've been experimenting a lot with brush pens in my sketchbook, whether they be the bristly ones that are softer and a bit juicier, or the slightly firmer felt tip brush pens. I really love sketching with them lately. I love the permanence in the line variation and how you can just go in with things, and if it doesn't work out, you just start a new one and you don't really get to piddle around and try to make it perfect. You just move on and try again. Speaking of trying to make things perfect, I erased a lot of stuff with this sketch and redid it. Actually, the sketch version that you're seeing here was my second attempt at this face. I had started drawing a face and then erased the entire thing and started over. And even between the sketch that you're seeing here and the final version that I'm going to be painting, I did go in and make even more changes. So it took me a little while to get this sculpted out the way I wanted to, but I started with my largest form, that biggest silhouette, because I knew if the gesture and the silhouette weren't correct, I wasn't going to be happy with the final piece. So I always start with my largest shapes and then carve out the details from there, because I know I need those big shapes to be correct first. As you can see, my sketch is very sketchy and I wasn't really hesitant about laying in darker lines because I'm going to be working with gouache, and I knew that I was going to be covering up most of those pencil lines with opaque paint. So I tend not to worry about it as much with gouache, and also it's in my sketchbook, so there's a bit of freedom there as well. You may have noticed that I'm not using gouache that I have used before. This is actually the ShinHan Pass, which is supposed to be like a gouache watercolor hybrid. I don't know a ton about this paint yet. I actually just recently got it because I had a bunch of affiliate credits over at Jackson's Art Supplies, which is thanks to you guys. I was able to pick these paints up. So thank you very much if you've ever purchased anything at Jackson's via my affiliate links. I try not to mention that sort of thing too often just because I don't want you guys to feel like I need you to purchase things, and anyway. But thank you, I was able to get these paints because of you guys. If you're interested in a more comprehensive review, please do let me know down in the comments, or if you've used these paints and you know any interesting things about them, you can let us know and we can talk about it down in the comments. These pages in my sketchbook were really my first few explorations with the paint, so I don't know a ton about it. I can tell that the consistency is a little bit thinner overall than gouache. It definitely does feel in between gouache and watercolor as far as the consistency on the palette goes, and at the same time, it's really nice to work with. I don't know the specifics of what makes this a hybrid paint. I believe it's actually a bit easier to reactivate than gouache that dries on a palette. When I had some bits, especially the white that dried up on me, when I got that wet, it reactivated really quickly and very nicely. So I'm enjoying it so far, but I don't know enough about the paint to make conclusive decisions as to whether or not you guys should buy it or what sort of role it can play in your collection of art supplies or how it compares to regular gouache or regular watercolors. I just got it and I'm playing with it and exploring. After laying in the first initial washes on this piece, I thought it would be fun to do something a little bit different than what I normally do, and I wanted to experiment with this ear in rendering out the whole ear first, so just playing around with building the structure in this one area, which is not usually what I do. I know I've talked to you guys before that I like to build things gradually all over the place, so jump in with a particular value all the way across and then work that way. So if I had put in the super dark parts of the ear, I would also put in the darkest areas of the eye and the nose and mouth and all of that sort of thing. But because this is a sketchbook exercise, it's a great opportunity to explore things and experiment outside of the normal way that I like to work, which is one of the greatest things about sketchbooks. And I'm excited to be making a sketchbook type video because you guys get to see a little bit of a different working process from me. So this is a lot more exploratory and I'm not necessarily trying to create a perfect finished piece. I'm just allowing myself to play around with different combinations of color and different ways of creating a piece, different ways of working things in and laying things out. That being said, I feel like I'm constantly telling you guys that I'm struggling with my art. And I know that growing and developing new skills is kind of always a struggle, so I'm trying not to be too hard on myself. But especially lately, I've just been having a hard time figuring out what it is I even want to be creating. In the past, I was able to connect pretty easily with exploring different ways to convey particular emotions or working in a particular process where I take reference photos, usually of myself. And for a little while, I was in a nice swing of creating pieces, and I really enjoyed working in that way. But since October, when I was exploring a little bit more illustrative type things, when I was thinking about comics again, since swinging between a sketchier style and then back into painting a bit more, I've kind of lost my footing a bit, and I'm hoping that over time I'll be able to reconnect with my inspirations and just figure out what it is I want to be making and what it is I want to be creating. It's easy for me to fall back into the type of things that I know how to do, so I feel relatively confident in drawing faces sometimes. I've been struggling lately, and I feel like I need to kind of go back to basics and understand a bit more of the form and anatomy of things and really just back up and allow myself to just find a new connection point, a new foundation for making art and creating things, because I'm feeling a little bit lost, and like I'm not exactly sure why I want to make art right now. I don't mean that to sound sad, because, you know, things change and progress and I'll find a new reason or a new connection point eventually, or just new creative grounds and a new place to stand, basically. I'm saying I know I'll get there, and this is just like a weird in-between sort of phase, which I feel like I'm in a lot, and I know a lot of people feel that way. I think a lot of it has to do with the constant noise of the internet, and for me myself, I know when I'm constantly seeing other people creating things, and it's not that other people are constantly creating things, it's just that there are so many people that it can feel like there's a constant flow going on, but everybody ebbs and flows. So I'm not creating things all the time. Even if I'm posting regularly, I may be posting work in progress things or a look at my workspace or things that I created a long time ago for different things, and it's not necessarily a constant flow, not even for me. And I know that that can be a bit discouraging sometimes when I feel like everyone else is constantly doing things and I'm stopping and going and not really sure of where I'm at a lot of the time, or not really confident in what I'm making, or like other people are doing what I want to be doing, but they're doing it better. And it's weird, and it's just so easy to compare ourselves to other people, not just in the type of work that they're creating, but the ways that they're doing it and the ways that other people are finding success. And it may seem a little silly for me to say things like that as someone who I feel like I've been relatively successful in establishing myself across various platforms. And while I may not always be comfortable and confident in the quality of my art, and you know, that imposter syndrome does hit me sometimes where I feel like I don't deserve the support that I have at some occasions. I know everybody feels that way sometimes, but I am exceptionally grateful for getting to do this and share this with as many people as I do. And yeah, I definitely, you know, question myself a lot. And I think when I do feel this way, one of the best things I can do is just detach myself from the internet, which I know I talk about a lot, but it is really important to be able to identify yourself and your art outside of the realm of social media and outside of the realm of YouTube or Instagram or whatever social platform you may be sharing your art on. Because when your identity only exists within the validation received from other people, you're eventually going to fall apart. You're not going to have grounds to stand on. And that is super, very important. Oh boy, we're in full rambly mode today. So thank you guys so much for enjoying content like this. I know it's just me talking and doing things. So anyway, thank you for enjoying this sort of thing with me. As I was working in my sketchbook, I finished up that first sketch. I say finished, but I don't know if I would consider it ever having been completely finished, because I definitely didn't get where I wanted it to go, but that's mostly because I didn't know where I wanted it to go. So I just let it dry and moved on to the next page and just kept exploring. And I kind of gave up on the idea of needing this video to follow a particular format of prepping for a piece, getting my ideas out there, and then creating the successful version of that piece, because I decided I didn't really want that to be the purpose of this video. It's just us hanging out in my sketchbook, almost as though we were hanging out at a park together or sitting in my studio together, me and you guys, and just painting. Sometimes stuff works and sometimes it doesn't. And that's okay. I moved on to my next page, just kept sketching, just kept exploring, and just kept recording. I was curious about how these paints would lay over top of dark ink lines. You can water it down to be much more transparent and very much like watercolor, which is a lot of fun, and you can gradually add opacity if you want. So I was really enjoying that. I wanted to try sketching directly with my paint and just seeing how different that feels. That's one thing I love about being in my sketchbook, is I'm able to try a bunch of different things quickly without trying to make each thing its own separate, individual, finished, fully realized piece. And once I get out an individual sheet of watercolor paper, I tape it down, I get into the mindset of I'm making a piece right now. And sometimes that's good, but when I'm trying to learn and I'm trying to answer questions, I talk about that a lot with art, how usually I start by wanting to answer a question. The quickest way for me to do that is often in my sketchbook, because I can work on something and it doesn't have to take as long. It can be quick, I can explore, and whether it's finished or not, I can just play around and then move on. This sketchbook is actually going relatively quickly for me. I'm more than halfway through it, and it hasn't been a full month that I've had the sketchbook yet. In my brain, I kind of have a tiny bit of a goal of finishing the whole sketchbook in a month, which would be by November 15th. I started this one on October 15th, and I think if I did a few more sketches and studies and experiments like this and continued to play around with the brush pen, which of course is a permanent thing, I could fill up a lot of space pretty quickly. I've been itching to get back into figure drawing, as I've been doing lots of portraits and faces, which is really fun, but I'm missing the overall expressiveness that the full body can portray, and I've never really gotten into the full swing of incorporating like the full anatomy in my pieces, which seems really intimidating to me because there would be so many forms to render, and I like my pieces to take less time than that, but I definitely want to take on those sorts of challenges in the future. So maybe I can just whip out a ton of figure drawing, like some quick gestures, like 30-second poses or 1-minute poses, and fill out this sketchbook really quickly. I think that that would be fun and it would be really great practice. Let me know if you guys would be interested in seeing something like that. Just some more sketchbook fun, some more playing around in here. Thank you guys so much for hanging out with me here. Thank you for entering the giveaway. I appreciate it so much. Congratulations to our winners. And I will see you guys in next week's video. Have a fantastic weekend. Bye-bye.